This is the weekly incubator, Salesforce incubator recap. It's week 11, I think.
No way.
Yeah.
Wow, time's flying. Yes.
Time flies when you have fun. And CRM Science is in the incubator, mentoring the other incubees in building AppExchange apps. Some of them are not really understand the ecosystem, the platform, and we're here to help them. And every week, Friday at 11, we're having this chat. And today with us, we have Jesse from CareerForce.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Jesse, tell us about CareerForce and actually why you're here in the incubator.
Sure. And so thank you for the opportunity, guys, to be here with you this morning on a Friday, beautiful Friday.
It is a gorgeous Friday.
So Jesse Martinez, I'm the founder and CEO for CareerForce. And so what CareerForce is, it's a new venture that's creating and developing that next generation of Salesforce administrators that come from our diverse communities, with a strong focus on those that are non-technical and non-engineering, as well as those that come from our community colleges.
Yeah, so that's actually, we've talked about it a little bit, and I feel it's a really important thing that you're doing. The ecosystem is lacking a lot of quality people already, and the ecosystem, according to Salesforce, is going to double in the next 3 or 4 years.
Yes.
So that lack of skill set is only going to get worse. So
Right.
diving into more diverse sources for talent is really important, I think.
So in your elevator pitch just now, you mentioned community colleges. Why is that a particular focus?
So what we typically find is that, one, there's a big shortage of just awareness around opportunities and tech.
Okay.
And so even if we look at the great, all the great schools that we have across
Now,
the
I'm going
country.
to speak up just a little bit because the acoustics in here are not
Okay,
great.
yeah, so we have all these great schools across the US. And so one of the things that, while working in tech, is that community colleges often get overlooked. And there's a lot of talent, right? There's a lot of talent everywhere. And so how do we ensure that we're bringing awareness around tech to these community colleges across the US? And that seems to be the number one challenge. The second challenge is that a lot of people, through my conversations and doing the work that I've been doing within the Latino tech community, is that our youth have this stigma with tech that they believe they have to be technical or be an engineer to work in tech. And that's not true. And so if we think about the average is about 70% of positions at these tech companies don't require you to be technical or to be an engineer. And so what we're doing is we're changing that narrative, right? We're going, instead of, hey, be a coder, be a programmer, be a developer, let's flip that and talk about what are these positions, what are these opportunities at tech companies for these type of individuals that aren't pursuing a coding or programming.
I can testify to the truth of that because last night after our presentation, one of the students came up to me and was asking me a bunch of questions. Clearly a bright guy.
Right.
Clearly had some great ideas and understood technology and business, but then he said, "But I'm not really sure where to get started, or even if I can, because I don't have a computer science degree."
Yes.
And I just said, "No, you've got it wrong.
Right,
You've got it wrong." Well, he says, "Well, you know, my degree's in business." Great. That means you understand the business problems.
Right.
That means you understand how you can be of value to people.
Right.
And so, if you want to pick up the tech, I'll help you figure out how to pick up tech, and so will you.
Yes.
But you know, some of that business savvy and some of that relationship and just understanding how to solve problems, sometimes you can't teach that, and that's almost more important than many of the positions,
Right,
right?
and so at community colleges, again, it's just, I've been approached by many during my conversations around CareerForce, and they're like, "Oh, by the way, I started in community college, or I graduated from community college, and look what I'm doing."
Oh,
And so I'm getting validation,
That's
right,
cool.
from others that, and also thank you, like, thank you for focusing on community colleges,
Yeah,
because
definitely.
we know that there's talent there. I've met some of the talent. And so again, it's awareness, right?
Yeah.
Awareness around, and not not just tech, but also what are some of the other career paths that, as you build the foundation as a Salesforce administrator, what else can you do, right?
Right.
Maybe you want to become a developer, right? Maybe you want to do sales. Maybe you want to become a sales engineer.
Right.
Maybe you want to do customer success.
And that's something that we talked about this week as well, because there's it, being as part of the ecosystem, you don't have to be a developer or an admin.
Right.
You can be a project manager. You can be, like you said, a customer success person. You can be support. You can write stories. You know, there's UX. There's so many things that, that people can be and that don't have to be developers.
Right. And to your point, some people just don't know where to start. And if you don't have enough of, you know, us, right, at these tech companies or others saying, hey, let me be your champion, let me be your sponsor, then, you know, you don't build a good pipeline.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Yes. So actually, you know, Sean was mentioning yesterday a student came to him. So we actually had a demo jam in the incubator.
Oh, right. Yeah, yesterday.
And we had a group of students from Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Come here, and they were actually, they voted, and Sean did the presentation for us. He did a great job. We came second.
Oh, second?
Okay. Yeah.
What happened?
Seinfeld.
So
I thought he was just going to say, hey, we got first place.
No, I never met up to that, didn't he?
Our friends from Junco that sit here next to us, they came first.
Okay.
But tell us about these group of students. How did they come about?
Yeah, what
here?
Program is this that they were involved in?
TREP Camp. So it's a playoff entrepreneur. And so this is the second cohort
mm-hmm.
that we've hosted here. The first one also from Mexico. And so they do, I believe, a 3-week boot camp. The
and
first one was at
Berkeley.
Yeah, these are over at Stanford.
Okay.
And so what was interesting about this second cohort is that actually, all the students weren't from Mexico.
Oh.
They had a global representation.
Oh, really?
Yeah, from other countries. And so that was different. So the first time that they do that, at least to my knowledge.
Yeah.
And so the way we connected with these students is just through the network of within Salesforce. So Pablo Quintanilla, I think they reached out to him.
Okay.
And then they know that I'm here. And so they thought it'd be great to show the incubator.
Yeah.
Tell the story around the incubator.
Yeah, right.
So Mike did a great job yesterday.
Yeah, absolutely.
Talk about the work the incubators do.
And they were very interested. It seemed like they're actually more prepared than the first group that came.
Mm-hmm.
They were. It seemed like maybe they were further into their program.
Maybe.
Because they had a lot more interesting questions.
Okay.
Interacted a little bit more.
Yeah.
A few people came to Sean and
asked
some questions.
I had a line of people, and you weren't there. So I just,
oh, yeah.
I just told him I was Jesse. And then he all kinds of really bad advice.
Thank you.
But it certainly validates, you know, the need out
right.
there, because these were really bright kids. They asked really good questions. They were engaged with all the speakers.
Mm-hmm.
And then they, you know, they were hungry for direction and encouragement afterwards. So that's great.
Yeah, well, that's great to hear. And, you know, as we look at building career force and validating our model here in the Bay Area, you know, we want to take it across the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
and take it to other communities. And so that's the big vision within the U.S. market.
Mm-hmm.
And then I strongly believe that we can take the same model and go to international markets. So when we think of Mexico, when we think of Argentina, when we think of Colombia, when we think of Cuba, and so what are those market opportunities to share the knowledge, create jobs, teach people about these skills, right? Again, what are those global opportunities for creating more career paths and leveraging the Salesforce ecosystem?
Yeah, absolutely.
Right? And then, I mean, there's so much work to do just within the Salesforce ecosystem that, I mean, you'll stay busy forever. But I think, you know, in addition, you know, some of the things that have come up in my conversations around career forces. Hey, what about high school students?
Mm-hmm.
What about those over 50? What about mothers returning to the workforce, right? And so there's other verticals that we can entertain over time, but I just tell people time out.
Yeah.
You can't do everything in one.
Can't do everything in once.
Just
So yeah, so I think U.S. market, other verticals, and then international markets will keep us busy.
What's the immediate next step for CareerForce?
So the immediate next step is being able to, or launching our first boot camp, which starts July 31st.
Nice.
And so we
congratulations.
Have, thank you. And so we have 30 spots.
Yeah.
And so we have the support of Academic Alliances that's going to facilitate a professor and then also provide the certification vouchers.
Mm-hmm.
So we're very honored and to have that support.
Outstanding.
From Shirley, Matt, and that team. And then in addition, being able to provide internship opportunities. So go through the training, internships. Also, we have a commitment from Tony Profit and his
mm-hmm.
team of quality to help provide an intern as well.
Fantastic.
So we're excited about that, and I believe you guys have also stepped up
yep.
to provide an internship.
Well, we do sit next to you. We can't hardly ignore you this whole
time. I know. So thank you for that.
Well,
yeah.
Your passion is infectious, and your mission is good. It's a good one. So.
Well, and from a practical perspective, it's really hard to find good people. So,
it is.
You know, again, if this is a source for really excellent people,
right.
Why not?
Right. Right. Yeah, and so definitely counting on, you know, my network, extended network, and referrals to ensure that we do reach these
right.
Talented individuals, right?
Absolutely.
Bay Area and across the U.S. And provide them the opportunity, and so and also being able to minimize the barriers so that they can focus on learning.
Right.
And so we have fostered some additional partnerships, such as Uber, Airbnb, LinkedIn, and Dropbox.
Mm-hmm.
And so
I've heard of all them.
Uber transportation credits, thank you.
Wow.
Airbnb, we're looking at housing vouchers. Dropbox, we're looking at mock interviews and resume reviews.
Mm-hmm.
And LinkedIn, same thing, being able to work on their LinkedIn profile.
Yeah.
And also mentorship and panels. And so I'm going in for my big asks.
Yeah.
And so ensuring that we have all the support and resources. And I can just thank you for all the friendships and partnerships that,
sure.
that we have here.
And actually, you're still looking for some people to help with creating some content for the program?
Absolutely. So when we think about education, you know, who are those guest speakers? Right? Who are people that can become mentors?
Mm-hmm.
You know, how do they help plug into the areas of like business skills, critical thinking skills, and then life skills?
Mm-hmm.
And so that we couple that with the Salesforce Administrator training, and so that we are developing this next generation of man leaders. And so thinking about what I went through, especially on the mentorship piece, it's so important that these young leaders have the mentors in their lives to help them as they go down their path.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
And actually, you're getting a lot of traction other than the fact that you have a program starting.
Yes.
I heard something
no
about
pressure.
The White House.
Oh, yes.
Sorry?
I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Actually, I need to write that up today. So last year, I was speaker, I was on a panel around diversity and tech at the Clinton Global Initiative.
Mm-hmm.
So it was my second time participating. And because of that, I got invited here in a couple weeks to attend the Department of Labor. They're having a White House gathering of the tech hire grantees.
Nice.
And so I'm going to be doing a keynote around diversity in tech.
Awesome.
Yeah, pretty excited.
And so when is this going to happen, and how can we hear the keynote?
Yes, so it's going to be July 25th and 26th.
Okay.
So just around the corner as well.
Yeah.
And so I need to work on my presentation.
Right.
I'm not sure if it's going to be live stream, but I'll be sure to ask.
Yeah. And I'm sure everyone would be interested to hear.
Yeah. So, excited about that.
Yeah,
so I'll get to talk about the incubator, CareerForce, Salesforce, and then all the partners that we're working with.
Yeah,
fantastic.
Absolutely. That's great.
Yeah, so it'd be nice to share with others what we're doing.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think maybe we should end up with Sean. He can tell us about the demo that you did yesterday. What we recently in discussions with the Einstein team, they wanted us to think about creating a layer in front of the APIs.
You can't really ask a developer to think about it.
And that's exactly what happened. Kirk from our team came back after a day or so, and he said, okay, it's over halfway already done.
Halfway done. So, yeah, Kirk wrote a great framework around how to or to make it easier to start leveraging the Salesforce Einstein language intent and sentiment APIs, as well as the Einstein vision APIs. And so now you can jump in, you just use the framework, and start making some custom Apex code to do some custom machine learning against those APIs. So that's pretty exciting. It's still, of course, you know, we're just getting started. And for me, the experience was yesterday morning, Kirk saying, here it is, go learn it and present it. So I had the quick crash course yesterday and then do a present, 3 minutes lightning presentation of the framework. So now I'm excited to help Kirk on the framework.
That sounds very cool.
Yeah, it is great. Because, I mean, everyone is so just anxious to get a hold of some things to do with Einstein. And obviously, Salesforce is releasing a bunch of features, which are great.
Right.
But developers are itching to do stuff.
Right.
And so as these APIs come out, everyone's going to jump in and try to do something. So, you know, try to leverage it. And so with our, are we calling it the AI Lab?
Quick Start.
AI Lab Quick Start.
Okay.
And that's going to be our framework that you can download and then get started.
Yeah, and I think it's one of the reasons why we actually thought it was a good idea was because there are features that are coming out, but that people can actually use, but it's coming out kind of slowly. These APIs came out really, you know, all of a sudden. We have access to 3 new APIs, but you still have to do a lot of development to get it going.
Right.
What we're doing is kind of creating a framework for you to start at the higher level and even get to a point where you can just be an admin and not do development on top of it. Not yet.
So
we'll be there.
Plug and play ultimately. Yeah. That's great. I'm fascinated by it, and, you know, especially what we can do or how do we leverage, you know, AI and Einstein for a career force. And so thinking over time as we get students to say, hey, I want to be a part of career force, getting them into the system and saying, oh, we've seen similar background before. Here are some career path suggestions after the Salesforce Administrative Foundation, right? And so taking the data, right, and leveraging it to reinforce and also help provide career path support.
Yeah, and we even talked about creating like custom paths through Trailhead and kind of tapping into that. And you can use AI to kind of determine the skill set of a person and maybe divert them into different type of skill through a platform that already existed, which is Trailhead.
Yeah. The pieces are coming together,
right?
Oh, they're definitely coming together. I think by the end of the year, a lot of these, right now, perceived gaps on applying machine learning are all going to be filled with various tools.
Right.
Both from Salesforce and from third parties like us. And then it's just going to exponentially grow. So it'll be exciting.
Right.
And I mean, Dreamforce is a huge catalyst to making things happen. So, I mean, the Salesforce team is super motivated to get stuff ready.
Yeah. Yeah. There's a few things coming up I'd love to talk about.
I bet. I've been thinking about, you know, just from a sales perspective, because I have a lot of those conversations and, like, okay, how do we take in all these data feeds, right? So the Crunchbase, the Matterport data, et cetera. And then that becomes part of the sales dashboard,
right?
And so, I'm excited to see that come to fruition.
As we are.
Yeah.
As well.
Very cool. I think that's all we have today. So, join us again next week at 11. Again, Fridays at 11 Pacific, 2 Eastern. Thanks a lot, Jesse, for joining us.
Thank you, guys.
And
thank you for the opportunity.
See you next week.
Thank you for your support.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
See ya.
See you guys.